The U.S. Air Force has used a C-130 for its electronic warfare compass call, which jams enemy signals. It's now moving from a legacy military plane to a business jet. Defense News' air warfare reporter Stephen Losey has been covering the transition and joined us to tell us more.
Steve, welcome to the show.
Good to be here.
You've been reporting on the Air Force's electronic warfare plane. There's a big change. What's your reporting showing?
The Air Force has been flying the EC-130 compass call in the Middle East for the last 20 years. They're now coming home with the end of the war in Afghanistan. But a lot of those airframes based on the C-130 are very old, dating back to the Vietnam era in some cases. And so the Air Force realized they need to do an upgrade and get some of that electronic warfare capability in a new, fresh airframe.
So they're going from something big, the C-130, to something small, a business jet, the Gulfstream.
That's right. The Gulfstream G550 is going to be the EC-37B compass call, the next generation of compass calls. And right now, L3Harris is working on modifying the first G550 to be ready to accept some of the electronics from the old compass call.
They're moving from a big plane to a small plane. Are the electronic warfare capabilities going to change at all?
No. In many cases, some of the original equipment from the old EC-130 is going to be basically done. They're going to do an organ transplant and put the old equipment in the new plane. Now, they've been heavily modifying the G550 Gulfstream jet to be able to accept this. That includes enlarging the nose, enlarging the tail, adding extra room in the side panels to be able to accept the radomes, the antennas, and some of the other electronics. Now, they're also, in some cases, putting some updated electronics in that do similar things to the old equipment, but use up-to-date technology, in some cases that's been smaller, miniaturized, to fit that in the G550.
It's interesting that the Air Force is going from a legacy aircraft to a business aircraft, but it looks like there's a lot of benefits on the maintenance side.
That's right. L3Harris says that the C-130, because it's a military plane, sometimes requires depot maintenance, requires some specialized parts. But the G-550, because it's a commercial jet, some of these parts are more readily available. It won't require as much time in the depots, won't require as much time out of commission while it's getting repaired.
Thanks for joining us.
Glad to be here. Thank you.
An engine contract, a unique customer for an American tanker, and a binational agreement to power a tank. All that in this week's industry headlines. General Electric just secured a contract with the U.S. Air Force to be the sole provider of engines for the F-15 EX Eagle II. The contract is worth more than $1.5 billion and calls for GE to supply the service with 29 engines. That'll fill 12 of the Boeing jets. Those engines include installs and spares. GE could eventually provide 329 engines in all for 136 aircraft. The last of those engines would be delivered in 2031. Japan will be the first non-American operator of the KC-46A tanker. Boeing has delivered the first of four KC-46A tankers to the Japanese government, and that's the first delivery of the aircraft to a customer outside of the United States. The aircraft departed Boeing's facility in Seattle on October 28th with the call sign Reach-46 and arrived at Miho Air Base in Japan the next day. The president of Boeing Japan said that the aircraft will play a critical role in security for both countries. He added that it will also support Japan's humanitarian relief efforts because it carries cargo and passengers. Turkey and South Korea have signed a letter of intent to cooperate on the Turkish Altay tank. The October 22nd deal states that two Korean companies will supply engines and transmissions for Turkey's indigenous vehicle. Turkish manufacturer BMC makes the Altay and has been negotiating the agreement with Korea's Doosan and SNT Dynamics. The companies will supply the engine and the transmission for the tank. Turkey had originally hoped to power the Altay tank with German MTU engine and ring transmissions, but those plans fell through. Are you into cybersecurity? If so, make sure to sign up for the C4ISRNet Cybercon. Here to speak about the November 10th virtual event is Executive Editor Mike Gruss.
Cybercon is our annual military cyber conference. This year it's going to be held virtually on November 10th. We have three keynotes we're really excited about. One is Lieutenant General Charles Moore. He's the Deputy Commander at U.S. Cyber Command. We also have Mickey Yang. She's the Deputy Assistant Secretary of Defense for Cyber Policy. And we also have Dave McCown from the Department of Defense CIO's office, Chief Information Officer's office, and he's the official there who oversees cybersecurity. And so the three of them will give a really great perspective on the state of cybersecurity in 2021 and going into 2022, and obviously from three different perspectives. General Moore will probably focus on the operational perspective. Mickey Yang will talk about some of the policies that are necessary to improve cybersecurity and to improve cyber operations. I think we've heard a lot the last year or so that generals have said, hey, they have the authorities they need, but I think what we're gonna be asking about is what else is necessary for that, for really effective cyber operations and effective cybersecurity. And then Mr. McCown will be talking about cybersecurity from a IT perspective. Obviously, the Department of Defense is one of those networks that bad guys around the world really want to get in. And so he'll be talking about the steps that are necessary to keep those networks protected. This year's event is going to be November 10th. For folks who are interested in registering, you can go to cybercon.c4isrnet.com.
Thank you, Mike. When we come back, tips for veteran entrepreneurs.